diagram shows the amount of money in Adam's savings account and the amount of money in Kim's savings account. So we don't have the actual amount, but the size of these bars tells us how the amounts relate to one another. For number one, the amount in Adam's savings account is how many times as much as the amount in Kim's savings account. Notice how we have the word here times, which means we're going to use multiplicative reasoning. Using additive reasoning, we can see that Adam's savings account would be 2 units more than Kim's savings account. But again, because of the wording here, we're using multiplicative reasoning. So for a quick review, when we talk about additive reasoning, we're looking at the absolute change between two quantities, where if we take the old quantity and we add the absolute change, we get the new quantity, which again is not the case for our problem. For multiplicative reasoning, we're looking at the relative change between two quantities. When using multiplicative reasoning, we begin with the old quantity and we multiply by the relative change to determine the new quantity. And we can always calculate the relative change by taking the new quantity and dividing by the old quantity. So going back to number one, the amount in Adam's savings account is how many times as much as the amount in Kim's savings account. So we begin with Kim's savings account amount, which should be 3 units, let's just say 3. So starting with 3, we need to figure out what we have to multiply by to get the amount in Adam's savings account, which would be these 5 units, let's just say 5. So to find the relative change, we need to figure out how many 3s there are in 5. Let's first think of this in terms of copies, meaning how many copies of 3 does it take to make 5? Well, notice here's one copy of 3 and 5. So that's one copy of 3, but we still have this extra amount. So if we take Kim's savings and cut it into 3 equal parts, as we see here, notice how this amount is the same as 2/3 the amount of Kim's savings account. So this amount here is 2/3 the amount in Kim's savings account, which means there are 1 2/3 threes in 5, or 3 times 1 2/3 equals 5, and therefore the amount in Adam's savings account is 1 2/3 times as much as the amount in Kim's savings account. Now, if we wanted to be more formal and calculate the relative change, which is equal to the new quantity divided by the old quantity, we would have the amount in Adam's savings account, which we'll say is 5 units, divided by the amount in Kim's savings account, which we'll say is 3 units. Units simplify out, giving us 5/3, which does equal 1 2/3. So we could also say the amount in Adam's savings account is 5/3 times as much as the amount in Kim's savings account. And now let's take a look at number two. For number two, the amount in Kim's savings account is how many times as much as the amount in Adam's savings account. Again, because of the language here, we know we're using multiplicative reasoning. And because the amount in Kim's savings account is less than the amount in Adam's savings account, the relative change is going to be less than 1. Using multiplicative reasoning, we begin with the amount in Adam's savings account, which would be 5 units or 5. We need to multiply by the relative change to determine the amount in Kim's savings account, which would be 3 units or 3. Notice how to answer this. We need to figure out how many 5s there are in 3. Well, we know there's less than 1 5 in 3. So if we take the amount in Adam's savings account, these 5 units, and cut it into 5 equal parts, how much of this does it take to make the amount in Kim's savings account? We'll notice how it takes 3/5 of Adam's savings to make the amount in Kim's savings, which tells us 5 times 3/5 equals 3, and therefore Kim's savings account is 3/5 times as much as the amount in Adam's savings account. Being more formal, we can determine the 3/5 by calculating the relative change, which again is the new quantity divided by the old quantity, which in this case would be the amount in Kim's savings account, which is 3 units, divided by the amount in Adam's savings account, which is 5 units. The units simplify out, giving us 3/5 for the relative change. I hope you found this helpful.